Right, guys, this is thing. This is my database, SAS. So this is the database. Under that, I have created user login and I have given the ID, position, username, and the password. I have taken for the school Amal and the password started with capital S hash 123. And this is the structure. Then this is my page. Okay, so these are some errors. We'll see. So from here, you can go to localhost. You all know why we are using localhost. Except I'm using to connect with the server. This is going with the PHP. So giving like this, then I have given MIT project and going to that directory. In that directory, there are some files about HTML development, guidelines, sitemap. These things, the sitemap JPG will put it to the image later, but for now, the login page, when I click, it will give the message with the JavaScript, welcome to SAS, use your username and the password. That means any person who is coming to this website with the URL, they knows the username and the password has to enter to the system. Then we can give select OK. So it will connect with the login form. So here we have to give whatever the names on the database. This is created by the authorized people that can be divisional head or the zonal director, but mainly that responsibility with the divisional head. So I'm taking Amal and giving here S hash 123. That is the school username and the password I have given. So we can click on login. When I click on the login, it will connect with this page and home. You can go to this one and the menu will be there. And the help sitemap is there. So anyone who is coming to this one with the sitemap thing, okay. And the guidelines, everything is there, right? Now for this purpose, I have used this code, PHP. So with the help of this part, I'm connecting my database with the system and taking this host, user, password, these things you all know. Now you are checking whether it's connected properly. If it is not connected, it will give the message SAS database connection failed, but now it's already connected. Then after that, with the help of this one, we are checking the post method and the username and the password. And remember here, when you are passing this username and the password, that is passing from our login form. So this is our form. So I have given hash. You all know why we have given a hash here. On the same page, it will connect and it will validate our data as well as we are using the post method because we are passing sensitive data, username and the password. So here, these things are there. Here we have given username and the password. The same thing we have to give here, okay? Right, and this has to display on double quotation. Otherwise, it will display this warning message. Warning, use of undefined constant username, assumed username. So what we have to do, we have to put double quotation or single quotation for this one. Okay, and here I'm taking a variable and here I'm taking a variable. And with the help of that two variables, whatever the things that you have input to the form will be assigned to this username and will be assigned to this person. Then the username and the password that you have entered will check with the database. So here with the SQL command, what will happen? We are opening the user login table with the help of the user login table, username and the password is there. We are checking. This is the things that we have given on this table, right? Username and the password. So we are taking this one. And here you can see we have given the select this and username and the password we have given that will check with the database connectivity. Now here, what will happen? The result will be taking as a query from the database and whatever the results that is from this one will be taken to SQL. Then $row MySQL fetch array. So whatever the results that you are taking, that result will be taken to array. And now you are checking the result. If is set to row, if it is correct, then what will happen? It will give login success in this page and it will load about system.html. That means our SAS system. If it is fail, if you have given wrong data, okay, wrong username and the password, what will happen? It will fail. I'll show you that also. Now here, when you take the page, look here, we'll go with this one. We'll go to our directory and we'll take the file. And here the SaaS will be loading, and Amal, we'll give Amal, and we'll give password is #123456 or something, and login. Then it will give login fail, try again. So it will connect with this one. If it is correct, as I have showed you, it will connect with the system. Okay, right. That's all for today.